throughout the exhibition, we've grouped objects typically by type. So you will find a particular type of helmet mask grouped together, a particular type of staff grouped together as an ensemble. So in many ways, installing an exhibition, presenting an exhibition like that is creating mini installations of art, where the installation helps visitors to look, read objects as individual works, but also make connections between objects. There are two groupings that I think are really great because the objects really gain from their comparison and juxtaposition with other objects. And in one case, it's little heddle pulleys that are very often decorated by the head of a hornbill. Those heddle pulleys are very simple, purely functional objects. They're used as part of a loom for weaving. There's a huge variety and diversity within that seemingly very narrow scheme. One object feeds from the other, and the whole grouping, the ensemble, is as a whole, I hope, a very compelling presentation and display. And the same is true with a group of small-scale figurines, mostly female, that are used in the context of divination practices in Senufo-speaking communities, or were used at least in the past as such, grouping objects together, showing profiles in one direction or the other, showing objects in three-quarter. You start to understand this richness, this diversity, and again, how ultimately endless the variations are on a given theme in a way that you would never even suspect by looking at one single object. But what does remain is the uniqueness of the object as such. And I hope that the display here at the Cleveland Museum of Art in this exhibition, Senufo Art and Identity in West Africa, conveys that idea in a very compelling and arresting manner.